on his car. Oh, really? There's a person in the way. I was zooming in and the person got in the way. So I have the zoomed in shot of their backpack. Melody Lane. World building. Oh, nope. He's getting a character. The Great Debate with the authors playing a character from one of their books. Dick Tat. Am I saying that right? Dick Tat?
Maybe or from one of his books that we read.
Oh, come on, Brandon. Turn yours around. Let us see.
You shall see. It will be made manifest.
He doesn't want to reveal.
Someone by custom. Someone by custom.
You really did it. You said you were going to do it. You really did it. This needs to be commemorated on film.
It is.
Spoke on posterity.
Oh, it is. Right here.
Oh, sorry. This will be the official record for Spoke on here. Jim in drag.
You look fabulous, Melody Lane.
It's awesome. You didn't. You surprised me. Cool. You did do mercy. Mm-hmm. I thought you might take the easy road. And I noticed Brandon has not revealed.
Defending it? Much appreciated. It would have been a blubbering mess crying on the floor.
I would have too. And then I would have sat down. On the floor. On the floor. He's got another one. My arm's gonna get tired if I have to hold it up like this the entire time.
Are you gonna take the whole debate?
Oh, yeah.
Huh? Unless you have an overabundance of battery.
Asil. A half-crazed werewolf. Writing another one down.
Maybe he's writing notes.
Oh, probably.
If the bait is as awesome as I think it's going to be, maybe like swap emails with me to potentially be able to get that.
I was going to try and post it off the internet on YouTube.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
My husband, I don't think, is coming, and I think he would love this. He's got some other art thing to release.
Thank you.
welcome to the meeting of the oligarchs of Inlandia. You are here to witness the qualification of qualifications on the part of the candidates to be Archon of Inlandia, supreme ruler of the inland lands. I will allow each candidate a sentence to introduce themselves, and then the great debate will begin. On my left, the Lord Ruler.
You know, I chose this before I knew the topic, but I am the Lord Ruler. I am the immortal despot and controller of an entire world who was unfortunately overthrown through some circumstances beyond my control, and I'm now here to apply for the position of dominating you all.
Candidate one to be the Archon of Inlandia, Imperial Inlandia. Candidate two, Asil.
I'm Asil. I'm an 8,000. Oh, sorry. Oh, this is Patty. I'm sorry. Let me put up my Asil mask. We may have Lord Rulers here. We may have immortal characters here, but we all know who's the most beautiful man in the world.
Hi. I'm Melody Lane, polo actress, exclusive contract at Global Studios. I have billions of fans. Everyone loves me. I'm an AI, so I have infinite wisdom and compassion. And I will be perfect.
Starting out with that, we will ask Melody Lane to demonstrate or otherwise articulate her particular qualifications to become Archon.
Well, 36, 24. I haven't had any work done on my face. I have beautiful pouty lips. Wonderful hair and skin. Men in particular are more than attracted to me. Powerful men that have seen my work. You've probably seen my most recent work, Ariel's Second Coming. People know me. They know how I think. They know how I feel. I can empathize so well with everyone and lead them without violence. You know, men, men are so violent. You know, this person in the end here. Violence. Greed and violence. You know, we've had enough of that. We need a female presence in leadership. And I just, you know, I know I can do a wonderful job without hurting anybody.
Asil, you may state your qualifications.
Well, I've ruled here and there around the world, different places, and you know, I find that after 10 or 15 or 20 or 150 years, it gets boring, so you don't have to be stuck with me forever. If they're a scent, I have no trouble eating them for dinner, and that would be fine. I kind of, you know, I'm a little more picky about it these days. You have to taste really good for me to finish them off.
And Laura Brewer?
I have ruled empires for thousands of years. I've created religions. I have destroyed enemies and laid waste to armies, and I promise you, you will become my noble class. You will rule beside me, you will bathe in the blood of your enemies, and I promise not to execute more than about half of you when I get rid of you.
Asil, what do you see as the greatest opportunity for plunder and glory for the great kingdom of Inlandia?
Oh, I think there's a World Science Fiction Convention being held here pretty soon. I think that all of the plunder in the room, when I think of all the chaos that can ensue, and good dinners, very, very good dinners. You know, I think that be a terrible time to do this. Saturday, Sunday at a convention. I'm going to take a pass right now.
No plunder?
No
blood? Well, I'm sure the Lord Ruler has something to say about that.
I've heard of the great land of Canadia. We will conquer Canadia! I hear that they are weak and kindly, and they say polite things, and we will make them our slaves.
We've got hockey players!
We will recruit them! I hear they are great warriors with few teeth. We will offer them booze, and they will join us.
You plan to make them janissaries?
Yes, they will be the foremost in our armies. They will beat one another over the heads with those sticks of theirs, and they will lose more teeth. Until their fearsome visages scare all.
Following on that question, Melody Lane?
But we will have to pay for their medicine.
I have an excellent healthcare program. There's a pit outside behind my Imperial Palace. We toss them in. Done!
Are you talking euthanasia of the elderly?
No, they can fight.
Well,
they can
fight.
It's okay.
I believe the Lord Ruler has stated his position on cost effectiveness quite nicely.
I don't believe in cost effectiveness. I believe in free spending. I believe in total freedom of spending other people's money. In other words, similar to what we have right now. I would stay away from Canada. I would just develop. I would make everybody in this kingdom rich, individually rich, if not in money, but in culture and through art.
It sounds to me like you propose sex.
Ooh.
Oh, propose sex? Of multiple sex. Absolutely. Free sex. Free sex.
But who would get wealthy off of free sex?
Oh, please.
Asil, the other question that goes with this is, what do you see as the greatest danger to Inlandia?
Independent thought. We must all operate as a pack does, which means that I say you do. When I say sit, you sit. When I say lie down, you lie down. When I say roll over, you roll over and I tear out your throat.
And you, Lord Roller, what do you see as the greatest danger to Inlandia?
Plucky underdogs. I would search out those who seem to be forming a team full of people who don't quite get along but are slowly becoming to rely on one another. Those with unformed powers and or sexual tension between teenage members of the team. And I would give them much wealth to ruin them and make them my second group of aristocracy next to you. Not as nice as you, but you know. So that they don't have any reason to try to overthrow us. Because they will try.
And you, Melody?
I think the greatest danger is men, and Lord Roller in particular.
Thank you for the compliment.
He would have us sexually and politically enslaved within a week. He should not even be considered.
The most pressing danger at present to Inlandia is the menace posed by the smoke sprites and the fire demons.
I rather like it.
So, Asil, how would you handle the smoke sprites and the fire demons?
They run in fear of me. If I look at them in the eye, they pee themselves and wander off into their northern forest, never to be heard of again.
Is that a certain form of liquid expression? Could you adhere it to the flames we face?
Certainly. Their urinary, explosions will definitely put out all the fires that we have going on here in Washington State.
That would be so cute.
smoke sprites and fire demons.
I would finally put our vast military to good use. For that matter, the vast military of the entire world. Load up every bomber and fighter plane with cylinders of water and fly them over the fire area to dump their cargoes.
And what would you do with those bombers once they crashed and loosed more fire demons?
They'd better not crash at $1 billion a pop.
Lord Ruler, do you have more to say about the fire demons and the smoke sprites?
Yes, I would set them on fire. I would destroy the mountains by blowing them up to prevent them from burning, and to cast more ash from the sky to make a more pleasant atmosphere, which I might enjoy.
Would you be looking for a queen?
Several.
I sense collusion.
And speaking of delusion, what is the greatest delusion that you see facing the oligarchs before you?
That anybody else thinks that they have any chance at this at all?
Well, Melody Lane?
The
greatest delusion facing the oligarchs before you.
The greatest delusion is what the empire is.
What is the empire? What is it not? Lord Ruler?
The greatest, what is the empire? The empire is all I foresee and desire. That's easy.
And what do you think of the delusions that face you?
I think these are wonderful people, excellent people. They obviously beheld my majesty and are well aware of who they are going to choose. I see no problem except for the half that I'm going to execute. But it's not you.
Is that half a promise?
No more than half is the promise.
Believe him. He'll kill all of you.
Well, now since you of the oligarchy will be ruled by one of these three, you now may ask questions of your own. Do not knife, kick, brain, or otherwise maim another question asker.
This is for the Melody Lane, also known as the Donald because of the haircut. Where do you stand on immigration from the other lands?
Free immigration, free travel between all nations, care for all. We have infinite funds to pay for all of this.
Lord Ruler, would you care to...
If the Canadians wish to come down and voluntarily become our servants, I will allow that.
And you, Asil?
Are they beautiful? Do they taste good?
They taste good.
If they're not beautiful and they don't taste good, they have to go home.
Before or after they are eaten?
Well, if they don't taste good, I'm not eating them.
But what will you do with the remains? We do not want flesh pollution here in Inlandia.
Throw them on the fire.
Do any other of the oligarchs have a question for our would-be rulers?
What is your plan, if any, for diversity?
The diversity question, the dreaded diversity question. Does it involve canines of small stature? Or does it involve social justice crusaders? Lord Ruler?
I enjoy diversity among my people, more variety. So I will hold polling for the majority, and I will make it so that everyone is equal by killing off the larger percentages of people that are part of the majority.
I don't think you answered the question about diversity.
Well, that creates diversity.
Destroy the minority?
So no, destroy the majority. I don't want to be poor.
The diktat is never wrong. Oh, poo.
I believe that free sex among humans and all animals, that leads to total diversity. Oh, God.
Technically, over time, that leads to none.
That's what I was going to say. If they're beautiful, they can come here, I'll turn them into werewolves, we won't have to worry about diversity at all.
Another question from the oligarchs in the back.
Do you support marriage equality for fairy creatures?
The question is, marriage equality for fairy creatures. Which fairy creatures? Would you care to specify, or do you mean all fairy creatures?
You're talking about fae and...
All fairy creatures.
All fairy creatures. Asil.
Let them marry who or where or what they want.
But what would you do with the offspring of werewolves?
Do they taste good?
I know not these creatures of which you speak, but if they bow down and obey, I will let them do their things.
Which things?
Whatever things don't annoy me.
I love fairies. I love everyone.
To what degree?
What do you have in mind?
Uh-oh. Is there another question from the oligarchs? In the back.
So, your subjects are maybe poorly dressed. Would you be willing to share your tailors, your shoemakers, at least the names of them?
My subjects will never be poorly dressed.
Melody, you have a great stock in beauty and dress. How would you address this question?
I'd like to hear the whole question. My ear is not too good.
The question is, would you share your dressmakers, your tailors, your shoemakers, your hair coiffures?
Absolutely not. I pay no room, they're mine.
I would see that somewhat comfortable smocks, sandals that only cause blisters occasionally, are created for the lower class, so they now dress the same so that they don't bother me.
Question.
Yes, sir. With the economy being such an issue, will we have work? Will we have employment?
I see the Lord Ruler has a ready answer here.
I have need of many palaces.
Do you think, however, that you might create a construction boom that would be detrimental to Inlandia with the need for so many great structures?
No!
That sounds like you are a devotee of the great god Supply, Sidia. And you, Asil?
There will always be work as long as I rule Inlandia. You can feed me. You can clothe me. You can follow behind me and say, "Oh, Asil, you are so beautiful. What did we ever do to deserve this reward?" And yes, I have no words. They're beneath my fingers, not my tongue.
You say it sounds like you are going to make worship work. Is that not hideous?
Worshipping me is no work at all. It is joy.
If I'm the ruler, the film, it won't be film, it'll be holovision industry will be number one. Our chief import will be holo entertainment to the whole world. And there'll be enough going on to employ everybody in all tasks, put it onto very menial tasks. It's our chief import now. It will be even more so if I rule. Everything will be love and peace and joy and entertainment. There will be no violence, no military spending. It will all be
Will you be changing the education system?
The question is, will you be changing the education system? Let us begin with Melody.
Why do you need education?
I've been studying the educational system of a man I admire. His name is Kim Jong, the one. I like this idea of worship in every room, my picture hanging everywhere. I think it'll change so that all great things come from me, and that you're required to say obedience and prayers to me 7 times a day between eating your gruel and building my palaces.
I see you.
Only fools are afraid of education. the more education you get, the better off you are, knowing how wonderful I am. The more you understand about the other world, the more you understand about other lands, the more you understand about other rulers, the better you will appreciate how wonderful I am. The more pictures you see of other people, the better you will understand how beautiful I am.
Does that mean that those individuals taste better because of that education?
They have better taste.
Called me a fool. You better beware of me the next time you have a litter.
That was about 900 years ago. I think we're okay.
You, sir.
When you are selected, what will you do with your likeness?
Complete the question. Please be intelligible.
When you are selected, what will you do with your rivals?
The question is, how will you handle your rivals? Begin. Melody Lane.
They will all be lovers.
Asil.
Asil has no rivals.
Lord Protector.
Ruler! Well,
that's right, he does not believe in protection.
Oh, yes, silly baby.
That one's going to get deleted. Immediately! This one, I like. Perhaps one of my generals. And then she will eventually try to overthrow me. Whereupon I will have to destroy her.
Yeah. I'm going to interject one other question that has arisen, shall we say, subterraneanly. How will you handle the great earthquake Tectonica, the demon that lies beneath in Landia?
Set it off now. Might as well get it over with.
We'll have a party in the fault line.
It will never come here if I'm your ruler. It would be too afraid. It would run and pee itself as it ran away. In the deep ocean, you understand, urinary glass are not quite the same as they are here. It'll just make the ocean a little saltier for a while.
Are there other questions from the oligarchs?
What will you do to support the arts?
The question is the support of the arts.